time this time around. What is that? That looks really bad. Do you need something? You need some ice or something? Can I get you something to help you out there?
Take some Vicodin if you got it.
Vicodin is something I cannot get you. You know that. Why don't you sit down? We've got some things to discuss. But first, can you tell me how that happened?
Let's just say it was a ding-dong ditch gone bad.
Johnny, aren't you a little old for ding-dong ditching?
I'm not too old for anything, Doc. If anything, I'm too fat.
Uh-huh. Okay, well, you know, we're really not here to talk about that or talking about your cut. We're really here to talk about your test results, which I have back.
All right, lay it on me.
You know, Johnny, I wouldn't be so cavalier about this. We tested you for some pretty serious diseases, one of which came back positive.
Positive, that's a good thing, right?
No, Johnny, in this case, positive is really not a good thing.
But I thought positive always meant something good.
Well, not always. It depends on the context. In the case of the healthcare industry, when we're talking about tests for diseases, positive is not good.
All right.
Well, Johnny, it turns out that you have a disease called celiac.
That cannot be good.
It's not. In fact, in your case, it's a very advanced form of celiac. It's a bad case.
What does it mean exactly?
And this is the hardest part of my job. Celiac is a disease that attacks the intestines. In fact, it may be responsible for those shooting pains you've been having in your stomach.
I'll just take some medication, and I'll be okay, right?
Well, I wish it was that simple, but medication will only do half the job. You really have to make a wholesale change in your eating habits. You have to stay away from certain kinds of foods, any food that has wheat, flour, barley, or oats in it.
Whatever it tastes like, I'll do it.
It's not that simple. You have to abstain from certain things. Cookies, breads, cereals, burritos. I've got some literature around here on the subject. I can give you something to read.
Literature? I thought after dropping out of college, I'd be done with that crap. Wait, you said burritos, right?
Yeah, I said burritos. The flour in the tortillas is... It'd be like, if you eat something like that, it's like injecting poison right into your system.
All right, Doc. I'll do everything else, but I'm not abstaining from eating Chipotle burritos. Besides masturbating, that's the only joy I have in my life.
It's an interesting point of view, Johnny. Not something I really can identify with or understand, but interesting. But all I can tell you is, it's all or nothing, son. You can't have your cake and eat it, too. As a matter of fact, come to think of it, celiac, can't eat your cake at all. Tell you what, I'm going to write you out a prescription.
All right, Doc, this is just a little too much for me. I got some thinking to do.
Wait a minute, Johnny. Hold on a second.